So we have 10 modules in total. So we're going to start with module number one. That is going to be the overview and architecture. Looking back, in this module, we are going to explore the ecosystem, the main components, technical architecture, the design and deployment considerations that you're going to go for. And lesson number one, the ecosystem and the main components. Talking about different applications that you have inside your D365 ecosystem, you've got sales, customer service, field service, finance and operation and talent. You have project service, retail, marketing, customer insight, etc. So if at all you are going to broadly classify it, you're going to have sales related application, services related applications, marketing related applications, etc. And for us, we are concerned about finance and operation. So finance and operation is going to provide you with various features where it lets you manage your finance, it lets you manage your human resources, it lets you manage your retail and commerce, it also lets you manage your supply chain. So you are going to make use of Visual Studio, which is going to be your IDE, the Integrated Development Environment, for all your finance and operation related development. So each developer is going to have their own instance of Visual Studio, and they're going to use Azure DevOps for source control. So whenever you are implementing finance and operation, you would either implement it on premises or on cloud. So how exactly are you going to decide what you need? So if it's cloud, you have like both pros and cons when it comes to cloud and on-premises. If at all you look into the common ones, number one, cloud is easy scaling. You do not have to invest in hardware or anything. You just have to like buy more subscription. That is like you can upgrade your subscription and you can increase your, you can scale your application very simply. And when it comes to on-premises, all the hardware requirements will be taken care of by your organization itself. So like scaling up or scaling down is going to be difficult. And the next thing is, you have a lower cost for your data center, your maintenance, etc. when it comes to cloud, because Microsoft manages it for you. While if you're going for on-premises, your company has to manage it by themselves. And a cloud, your implementation time is going to be shorter. You can stay current. You can easily upgrade or update your system using your on, which is hosted on cloud. When it comes to on-premises, you have to manage your own hardware. You have to manage your own services. The security requirement has to be taken care of by yourself, by your organization, and also your disaster recovery planning. So your backups has to be taken care of by the company itself. So it's up to you. It's up to the company where they have to go for, whether they have to go for cloud implementation or the on-premises implementation. So your development and deployment, where exactly do you develop? You develop your code inside Visual Studio. So your development, it takes place inside Visual Studio. Each day you get the latest code in order to reduce the conflict. You perform a local build. And once you do that, you can check in your code using Team Explorer to Azure DevOps. So we have seen how do we check in the code using your Team Explorer to Azure DevOps. And inside your Azure DevOps, you will be using a build pipeline, creating a deployable package. So your entire development and deployment process, to short that, development takes place inside Visual Studio. And each developer is going to have his own instance. He's going to connect his Visual Studio to Azure DevOps. And every day is going to perform a get latest, perform a local build. And once he is done with his development, he can check the code back in to his Azure DevOps using the Team Explorer. And inside your Azure DevOps, you can make use of your build pipeline, create a deployable package. Once you create a deployable package, you can apply this package onto your system using your Apply Updates tool inside your LCS. So once you apply that, you'll be able to view that inside your production, your live system. So whatever changes that you have done will be viewed inside your live system, but after you apply that using your LCS. So it is possible to create a deployable package using Visual Studio, but we do not recommend it. always make use of the pipeline inside your Azure DevOps to create a deployable package. So since you have like multiple people working together, so we do not recommend you creating a deployable package from Visual Studio. And also Microsoft as well applies updates to your production environment in the cloud. So I hope this is clear. Any questions you have at this point? Any more confusion related to lifecycle services and Azure DevOps? You can ask that in the chat box. Or you can ask it. Yeah, perfect. Now, we have seen the most commonly used user interfaces, like you have your navigation search. So, one second. So we'll discuss about action search in a while. And we have seen workspaces, we have seen user personalization. All right, so we need to discuss our action search, task recorder, a few things more. So we'll do that. So here you have your finance and operation. We've seen what are workspaces. You see the list, the tiles arranged over here are your workspaces. You can even access those from the list of workspaces that you have on the left side of your window right here. And for your modules, let's say that talking about accounts payable, let's go inside accounts payable. You have vendors, all vendors. So if you go to accounts receivable, you'll be seeing all customers page. So let me go inside all customers page. Here we go. And so here, once you are inside a particular form, there are multiple actions that you can do. So these are the different actions that you can take care inside your form. So any actions you want to search, you're going to use this particular search bar right here. So this is your action search. So your options action is right here. So using your options action, you have added this particular page inside your workspace. So each actions are going to do different things. You have different things to do inside each actions. To search for a particular action, you can use this action search button right here. You can simply search for it. So now I'm going to try creating a customer. And while creating a customer, I'll also try recording the task. So what is a task recorder? Just like you have your screen recorder on your phone, whatever you do inside your phone that is getting recorded using your screen recorder, we do have a task recorder. So I'm going to go inside task recorder. So whatever task that I perform is going to be recorded inside my task recorder. I'm going to click on create new recording, provide a name. So I'm going to say that this task recorder of mine is going to create a customer. Click on start. So whatever I do, once I click on start, the steps that I perform will be recorded. I'm going to go inside accounts receivable, customers, all customers. So once I go there, the particular task that I just did got recorded. You can see go to accounts receivable, customers, all customers. I'm going to click on new. So that is going to be recorded right here. It says click on new and provide an account for your customer, a name, details. I'm going to select a group from the list of record customers here. Over here, I'm going to click on that, save. So once I added all the important things, all the necessary requirements for creating a customer, so everything is done, and I'm going to click on save. All right, the saved, I'm going to stop it. All right, so once I have my task recording, I can save the recording to my PC. So it downloads an AXDR file. Save it. And also, if I want, I can save it to my lifecycle services. I can export it as a Word document. There are different things that I can do. I can save it as a developer file that downloads an XML file for me. So a task recorder has multiple uses. Number one, you can use it for training purposes. Once you have a task recorded, you can use that recording. You can share it with your co-workers so that they get to know, like, you have a new employee of yours and you want to show them how exactly to how to create a customer. So you might want to send these task recordings to them. Or, like, for example, if I export it as a Word document, the steps that I just performed, you can see the steps written inside the Word document. So you can easily pass this Word document to one of your, to your coworker, to your junior or your colleague, and then let them know that how exactly you create a customer. So that can be done. Also, you can save it to your lifecycle services so that others can also access it. You do not have to manually send it over. They can access the file directly from lifecycle services. You have a library called BPM, Business Process Modeler Library, inside your lifecycle services. So that's where you're going to store all these kind of documents in. And I'll be showing you all that in a while. So you can save it to your lifecycle services so that everyone can access these files, so that they can access these task recording. And then the next usage of it is, number one was your training purposes. Number two, you can use these files for automating test cases. We'll be discussing all that in the future modules. How are you going to use your task recording to automate your test cases, to automate tests? You're going to use it with other testing tools for automating testing. And there are, like, other usages as well. We'll be discussing one by one whenever we are discussing a particular module and what this task recorder has to do with it. So we'll be discussing that. So this is about your task recorder. I hope it is clear to you. As we've seen, we have seen what is a task recorder. We have seen what is an action search. Now, talking about office integrations. So office integration is another important thing that you have. So let me go take you to all customers page. Here you have a list of customer. So now, if at all you want to integrate it with Office. So you can see this is the button right here. It says open in Microsoft Office. And here I have two options. Either I can export it or I can open it. I'm going to select open in Excel. I'll show you what is the difference between the both. I'm going to click on download. Open. Click on enable editing. And now this is an important step. Click on trust this add-in. Sign in. Use your username and password to sign in. All right. So once the data is refreshed, the data I have inside finance and operation will be populated in here, will be listed in here. So now I can create, I can add a new data, a new record. I can make some changes to the existing record. So whatever changes I do here, for example, this Contessa Europe, I'm going to change it Aisha Contessa Europe. Whatever changes I do, I click on publish. It gets published onto my finance and operation in real time. And here's, you can see Contessa Europe, and it has to change into Contessa Europe, Aisha Contessa Europe. I'm going to refresh the screen and let's see. Let me close this and relaunch finance and operation. I'm going to take you to all customers page. There we go. And you can see Contessa Europe has changed itself from Contessa Europe to Aisha Contessa Europe. And also, if at all I'm making any changes in here, so this name, let me change it back to Contessa Europe. Save this change. Go to my Excel sheet. Do a refresh. The change has been refreshed back to my Excel sheet. So this works real time using O data. And here you can see I can integrate finance and operation with Excel in real time. So when you are using the other option, export to Excel, you are only exporting a static file where you cannot do this real-time integration. But when you open this in Excel, you can do real-time integration. You can add new records inside, whatever changes you do inside here. Once you click on publish, it will be published onto your finance and operation. And whatever changes that you do inside finance and operation, when you refresh it here, the changes will be refreshed onto here. All right.